world of Toby, very, very intense. Mm. And in the film, you have to be quite mean to your mum, played by Kelly MacDonald. Surely, that is the worst thing as an actor, having to be mean to a legend like her. What was it like working alongside her in the film?
It was wonderful. Like I've seen Kelly's work for a long time, and I think she's amazing. So it was very exciting working with her. She's absolutely lovely as well. Aww. So to be horrible, I mean, there's a bit like it's pretend horrible. So in a sense, the scenes are very meaty. So you're kind of like, as an actor, you're like yes. As a person, you're like no. But I kind of love the sort of what those scenes are kind of are about is that, you know, Toby's this kind of anarchic kind of freedom fighter, this intense guy, but ultimately he's not been very nice to his mum, and it's a kind of fallible, truthful other side to sort of the person that he projects a lot of the time, and I like the kind of the truth of that sort of knottiness. So it was good to do, but not very nice to be. Not nice to Kelly, because she's lovely.
People are like, sorry. And obviously the character of Jay, lots of different dynamics with loads of different characters in the film.
Yeah.
So what was your most like enjoyment to play? Was it the father side, the friend side, the boyfriend side?
Oh man, yeah, there is different sides. I think, I definitely enjoyed each of them differently. I think I've not done the father side before. I think my baby face doesn't So like, it's the first like project I've done where I'm like, yes, I'm playing like an older character here. Yeah, but I think definitely like just that dynamic and working with Rada, she's incredible, man. And we had a baby on set, you know, so that was also something as well for me to kind of like learn and take in. I think we had like the baby crying like between shots as well. So it was just like, okay, how can we still like maintain everything? And, you know, we had such a good crew. So, you know, everything kind of went to plan. And, you know, because he's here, I have to say, just working with this guy, man, he's a legend. So like the friendship stuff as well was cool, man. Like we had like a short window to kind of like do a lot of our scenes in. So, you know, we had to kind of quickly, you know, get to those places in the storyline and just really think about those scenes, because they're so, I guess, quite pivotal to the story, you know, very early on in the film. So yeah, it was amazing to do everything, but yeah, definitely working with these guys.
Oh, that's so cute. Now obviously you guys are basically like brothers in the film.
Yeah.
Do you ever hang outside the film at all?
Bowling
karaoke, like
bowling karaoke.
I mean,
you wore your bowling shirt.
I mean, I did spot. He's got the bag in the background. He's about to go.
I'm sort of like kind of farmer chic is what I'm going for. So we do hay baling together.
Definitely, man. Yeah, like we're just saying, like, just it's always incredible where you get to like obviously work on projects. And sometimes, you know, you work with people and it's, you know, it's difficult to kind of keep in touch and stuff. But yeah, you know, I'm thankful that, yeah, like we both, yeah, kept in touch. And yeah, man, like,
But bowling, we haven't done bowling yet.
It's on the list.
And obviously, both of you have a bit of a tussle with Hugh Bonneville. He's a bit of a legend.
Yeah.
Was that actually him, Lord Grantham? Like, or was there a stunt double when you were having your fight scenes?
That's all Hugh.
That's
you know, all out, all the physicality, all the kind of the darker side that people will get to see. It's all Hugh. So it was a wonderful, terrifying, thrilling thing to be up against and playing with.
Who's the real deal, man? Yeah, those front flips he's doing. Yeah, that's him, man. I'm telling you.
I mean, what would you say the main message of I Came By is trying to get across in the world?
I think we said it earlier, isn't it? Just how basically institutions sort of fail us. And I think the film covers just sort of different layers about that, do you know what I mean? Through family dynamics as well and just with, you know, with the sort of, yeah, that the system and the sort of, yeah, Hugh's character and what he presents basically.
Mm.
What would you say?
Yeah, I think there's this social message inside of like genuinely exciting thriller. Mm. And I think Babak wanted to see, he's wanted to make this film since film school, and so he said he always wanted to do a neo-noir thriller in London, the kind of the films that he loved growing up, but doing it sort of in the modern London. So I think it's that, and then underneath it, as Perse said, it's a kind of, there's the social message of our responsibility to institutions and responsibility, the institution's responsibility to us as well. And the be that sort of like government, socially, family, friendship, all those different types of kind of loyalty and institution and how they serve us and how we serve them.
Mm. I mean, it really makes you think, definitely. I was like, oh, I wasn't expecting other twists and turns. It was great.
Yeah.
Now, what is next for you, Purcell, in the world of acting?
What's next for me? I mean, yeah, I guess for people who have seen the kind of things I've done before, it's more just sort of creating my own opportunities, really, you know? So, you know, we did something called Shower Story a couple of years ago, and so, you know, we've got a few things lined up. But yeah, definitely for me, I just want to produce and write and yeah, just create more films. Man, if I could hold a camera, I probably would. Or sound up. Yeah.
Come on, jobs, everyone.
I do everything. Yeah. Look, just give me, yeah. So I think, pipeline-wise, yeah, looking forward to just telling more stories and stories that, yeah, like, you know, I could be a part of, you know, in the back, yeah, as well as behind camera as well.
So is that
Warner
Productions?
Yeah. That's also exciting as well. Like, being able to be an actor and also just, like, working with, like, Philly, Chunks, Harry and being a part of their journey too. So,
it's a good gang.
We got a lot of projects for the gang.
Oh, I love that. Now, I've got you here in the room, so I'm going to stoke the fire. I know you've been asked a few times, but I'm going to do it again. Have you been approached to play the next Bond?
No, I've not.
And I wish you had, you wouldn't tell me.
Yeah, but genuinely, if this could, you know, I'm asking. No. But I mean, it's a lovely rumor, but there's no news my end.
Okay. And he should. Hey, listen, call the people. Yeah.
Cheers, Percy.
You've got a good mate in him.
Yeah.
And finally, obviously both your characters leave a joint tag saying, I came by. Mm. If you were doing this stuff in real life, what would be your individual tags?
We came up with them, I think. Because I was thinking, like, Toby, his was bugs. Because when I was deciding upon the tattoos that he's got, the initial idea that rather than the Joker on his back, and I think it came down to a question of rights, is I was like, I think someone like Toby would have a poor choice. So I wanted a giant Bugs Bunny on my back, because also there are these kind of slight kind of conspiracy theories that actually Bugs Bunny is the ultimate anarchist and represents anarchy. So it turned into a mixture. No, it was Bugs and then Loon.
Yeah, Loon.
And then
yeah.
Because of Looney Tunes, and then also he's a kind of night crawler at night, it was Loon. Yeah. So mine was Loon. That was my tag.
That's amazing. Down the rabbit hole.
Yeah.
What would yours be?
Quite literally.
I wish I had a really good explanation for my one, but my one simply, I think I just said J.
I mean, top notch originality.
You know, I was just getting used to, like, actually, like, perfecting the technique and stuff, because we had to learn, right? So, yeah, I was just trying to, like, just study how to actually just do it with the one letter.
So you didn't go with the S. Yeah. You know that one.
I can do that. Yeah.
That's been my one.
We nearly changed his character to Stanley. Just so we could do that.
He's done it so well. We needed to get his skills out there. Thank you both so much. It's been great chatting with you today.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. We'll be right back.